Well, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Portal Masters of all ages. That's right, it's Brylander with Portal Power TV, and I'm coming to you with another episode of Skylanders Reimaginators, where we're reimagining other characters in Skylanders Imaginators using only the parts that they give us. And of course, we've just got a whole list of new parts, but I think this character's not going to need them. I think I'm going to be able to make it out of the old one. But like I said at the very beginning of the video, I think I'm creating sacrilege here. I think I'm kind of crossing I'm crossing a boundary or a line somewhere along the line. But if you guys are willing to get a little risque with me, we're going to create Jax, the Tyrax, who many of you probably don't know because the game hasn't come out yet, but there's a new game called Lightseekers. And one of the main characters that's in that, one of the main playable characters, at least at launch, will be Jax the Tyrax. And Jax is a technology-based species, or the Tyrax are, and Jax is one of the main characters, playable characters, and also they have, you know, the big 7-inch toys that will Bluetooth into their game. So it's a new Toys to Life game. And, you know, like I said, Skylanders, and there's a bunch of things going back and forth. Are they copying Skylanders? Are they going to be as good as Skylanders? Are they going to be the death of Skylanders? And all that kind of stuff. And I don't think so. I think there's plenty of room, for me at least. I personally don't think that Toys to Life is dead. Still got a few more good years in it, one way or another. And so I just, you know, I started looking at the parts and realized, you know, I could make something that looks similar to Jax. He actually played in Skylanders, so we're going to just have a little fun with this. This isn't meant to you know, make anybody upset or anything like that, but we're just going to have a little bit of fun, and I'm gonna make Jax the Tyrax from Lightseekers, and we're going to play him in Skylanders Imaginators. So before I go and continue to babble on, let's put a tech creation crystal on the portal, because the Tyrax are a technology-based species.
Welcome to the Creation Crystal, Portal Master. Here, you can create your very own Imaginator. Best choose a battle class. Each class uses a unique type of weapon.
Alright, and so I do have Jax actually as a smasher. One of his weapons is definitely a hammer of sorts, and so I am going to make him a smasher. So let's go Tech Smasher.
Smasher Imaginators pulverize their opponents with enormous smashing weapons. Are you ready to create a smasher? Choosing a battle class is a final decision.
Sure it is. Yeah, you just keep telling yourself that.
A new smasher is born. Now, bring your imagination to life.
Alright, so we now have our Tech Smasher created, and we can go into our creation mode here. So, real quick, I'm going to pause for a second. I'm going to show you this picture. This is actually one of the prototypes that I got from PlayFusion for the Jax the Tyrax toy that Tomy will be making. And it Bluetooths in with the game for Lightseekers. Just wanted you guys to show that. So, I've actually been getting to beta test the game. We're not supposed to talk about the gameplay at this point, so I'm having to reserve all that for when they tell us it's okay. But and I will absolutely be covering more of that particular game when we're able to. So anyway, back to creation in our Skylanders video. Let's see, body, head, and I basically need to figure out what head am I going for. So let's find where I'm putting it. Start up at the top and then work my way down. So if we can find our dragon head. Oh, I undoubtedly pass it. Here we go, right there, dragon head. And what do we got next? We're going eyes. I think I went with glowy eyes. And that's because the toy itself actually lights up and his eyes light up. So we're going to go with that route. And for the ears, I don't have any ears on Jax, and I don't know that he has any ears. But for the chest, I think I recognize the chest I used. It used to be at the top, but since the more parts have come into the game, some things have shifted around a little bit. So, where did I put it? Was it at the top or was it at the bottom? It might have been at the very bottom. Let me check almost at the bottom. There we go. All right, so we used this exoskeleton chest. And for the arms, I'm pretty sure that's the raptor arms, if I'm not mistaken. And then for the legs, it would even be the raptor legs. There we go. And then for the tail, what did I use? That might be the alligator. What did I use? Oh, I think it's up here. Yeah, I think I used the croc tail for this. And go back a step. Let's see, for the weapon, really the only thing that I found that was even remotely close to what his weapon would look like would have been, let's see, where is that club at? Was it the Great Hammer? I believe it was. So that's just the closest. They really don't have one that looks like his weapon. And gear. So headgear, we do have something on here, and this actually kind of gives it more of that Jax-like look. There we go. And let's see, shoulder guards. We're looking for the IC shoulders. And these just happen to look the closest to what his had. Not really getting as close, but I mean, it's getting there. So I think it was these shoulder pieces that I used. And then for the arm guards, the all-seeing eye arm guards, which I'm trying to think that's them right there. All right, so leg guards, there are none. And backpack, in this particular case, I didn't put a backpack on them, although backpacks are, flight packs are available in the Lightseekers game. And if you plug flight pack into the toy, you can actually use it to control and fly your figure on screen. So I'm going to glance at these really quick, but I don't see anything other than, you know, maybe that might even remotely look like the flight pack that he had. You know, of course, that kind of could work, but you know, you don't have to have a flight pack on them. So nothing's really screaming out at me saying, I mean, I could kind of maybe use that if I wanted to and say that's his, but for now we're not going to put one on. So all right, so we're going to go back a step and let's go over to his sizing. And this is what I pretty much did with him. From a size perspective, let's see, upper body kind of stayed the same, muscles, I cranked them up most of the way, tail width, left that about where that is, and then for the lower body, I cranked that up a couple notches, so I think that upper body, I might want to take that up one more. He's pretty beefy dude. There we go, that looks good. See my lower body. That looks all right. Let's see if the head. He's actually got a really small head itself, comparatively. So, anyhow, I think from a size perspective, this will work for me. And the next thing is the coloring. So I'm just going to color him in and let you kind of watch everything, you know, happen and so forth. And then we'll take a look at him at the end here. So here we go into the colorization. Alright, so this is Jax the Tyrax from Lightseeker's game that's due out this summer. It's currently in beta testing. I think they're in their third phase of beta testing. Let's see, what else do we have? So personality, we're going to call him... got to take ownership of this toy. Now I can name him. And he is Jax the Tyrax.
I shall respond to this name and this name only from here on out.
All right, and so for voice,
check out my barbarian magnetism.
That one kind of just works, but not sure.
Check out my barbarian magnetism.
So we're gonna go with this on the voice. And music and effects, I'm actually not gonna use any. So that is pretty much our Jax. Let's take a look at him here in the game. So I'm gonna tell you right now, there is a screenshot of Jax. And let me see if we've got it here. What do you think this guy looks like? Let me actually take this guy into some place that I can get like a zoom in on him. I think it usually works really well in the arena because we can zoom in a little bit better and see more detail on this character. Da, 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 da. All right, so we're gonna go into the battle arena real quick.
Battle arena.
All right, so here we go with Jax in Skylanders Imaginators, and over here on the right is Jax in Lightseekers. So what do you think? Kind of a rendition, what it would look like if Skylanders had designed him instead. And there we go. So I'm gonna head back out real quick. Let's get a kind of a zoom in there. I don't wanna take a selfie because I think I'm full on the gallery. But let's also, we can do his magic moment. And like I said, we're gonna head outside. Alright, so there we go. Let's do a surprise attack. Let's just do one of these with our Jax the Tyrax using his smashing weapon, because that's mostly what he does. So if you missed any of my Jax the Tyrax or my Lightseekers videos, I'll try to remember to put a link in the description below, but at the same time, just check out, go back a few in my channel and check out some of those Lightseeker videos, just talking about the unboxing of this Jax the Tyrax toy that I got, and I can't wait to get to do some gameplay, of course, for you.
New night weapon.
No, don't need that. All right, I guess last but not least, let's chirp him out. For those who knows what this is, here we go. All right, that's it. All right, guys, I have a serious question for you guys. So, did I completely, oh, what's the word I'm looking for? Did I completely betray Skylanders with this video? Did I betray them? Is that what I just did? I can guarantee you that's not the intent. I'm just having fun. But who thinks it's funny? who plans on making Jack the Tyrax and playing him in Skylanders? It's too bad we can't do it the other way around, right? Is play our Skylanders in Lightseekers. That would be even funnier. So anyway, looking forward to the game, guys. I mean, I've been playing it a little bit. I'm not allowed to talk about it, like I said earlier. But when it fully releases and seeing the figures come in fully painted, because of course you've seen my prototype is unpainted, and they look so much better fully painted. And we've seen box art and everything else, and a lot of people are covering it on Instagram. A lot of people are kind of excited about it. So, you know, we definitely, with the loss of Disney Infinity and some other toys to life, it's just nice having something else to come back in and keep this genre of games alive. I personally love Toys to Life. It's what I started this channel on. And hopefully, you know, we see Toys to Life at least for a few more years to come. And then newer innovations and stuff like that will come out. Hopefully will keep the whole genre of games, you know, alive. And I really enjoy it. And hopefully, you know, we get a little bit longer with some LEGO Dimension stuff. And then, you know, who knows what's around the corner. You know, Skylanders maybe, you know, they've taken this year off from a console game. But rumors are that we'll get, you know, of course, we know we're getting a mobile game in 2018. No telling when we'll get a new console game. But hopefully they're just really planning for a super pack-in-the-face, amazing, you know, next game with an amazing gimmick to it that we're all going to love. And hopefully it'll have PvP. Are you listening, Activision? Hopefully it'll have PvP. So anyway, guys, appreciate you being here with me. I'm going to go ahead and end this video, and if there's anything you'd like to tell me down below in the comments, please don't hesitate to do so, and by all means, don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment. So we'll talk to you next time. This is Brightlander with Portal Power TV, signing off. Take care, and God bless.